Welcome to the viewers for the lecture on structural analysis. Now we are discussing the topic on cables and suspension bridges. In the last two lectures, namely lecture number 71 and lecture number 72. So first, in lecture number 71, we have introduced cables and suspension bridges, the different components of a suspension bridge and their functions. And we have discussed that the cable is the main load carrying member, and the cable will always carry only tension. It will not be subjected to bending moment or shear force. So the main load bearing member is the cable, and we have discussed the basic formulas to find out the vertical reactions VA, VB, then the maximum tension T max, the length of the cable S, where L is the horizontal length, D is the central dip. So using this, how to find out the length of the cable S, and of course if stress is given, how to find out the area of the cable. So these are the different parameters that will be involved in the analysis of cables without stiffening. We have to start with, we have done something on cables without stiffening girders. In cables without stiffening girder, after discussing the basics and the basic formulas, we have discussed about a problem on cable supported at the same level subjected to uniformly distributed load. So we have discussed how to find out the maximum tension, how to find out the length of the cable. We have done one full problem. The problem is very simple, because when the cable is supported the same level, we know VA equal to VB equal to PL by 2. The horizontal tension is equal to PL square by 8D, and the T max equal to root of V square plus H square. That we have discussed in the earlier class. And for a designer, they will require what is the value of maximum tension, then what is the cross sectional area of the cable that is required, and what is the length of the cable that is required for getting a horizontal span of L and a dip of D. Right, that is for a designer's need. But from examination point of view, using the same formulas, they will give all data. You may be asked to find out what is the value of L, or they may give the required details, what is the maximum dip, or what is the area of cross section. By giving all values, what is the horizontal tension? So like that, giving some required values, you will be asked to find out some value. That will be the different types of problems. And that also we have discussed. After discussing one numerical problem on cable supported at the same level, we have discussed what are the different types of problems that are possible in the case of cables without stiffening girder and a cable supported at the same level. Right. Now, next, in the next lecture, lecture number 72, we have discussed a problem. Now we know that the cable is supported by, the cable and the deck slab are connected by means of closely spaced suspenders or hangers, through which only the load gets transmitted as uniformly distributed load. Right. Now, suppose if the suspenders are not closer, suppose if you provide one suspender for every 2 meters or 2.5 meters, then there is no possibility of transferring the deck slab load. The load from the deck slab will be transferred to the cable in the form of uniformly distributed load. Suppose you provide the hangers at a distance of 2 meters, 2.5 meters, etc., then there is no possibility of transferring the load as uniformly distributed load. The cable, which is completely flexible, will become into a number of straight pieces. So when it becomes number of straight pieces, how to find out the length of the cable, how to find out the maximum tension, that we have discussed in the lecture number 72 as the first problem, cables subjected to concentrated loads. Then we have taken a problem on a cable with the supports at different levels. supports at different levels. So that we have discussed, and we have discussed a problem on that, and we have found out the value of the horizontal tension. So there we have done one problem. Again, as in the case of cables support the same level, there also they may give all values, you may be asked to find out the value of D. All values they may give, you may be asked to find out the value of T max, or after finding out the T max, by giving the stress, you may be asked to find out the area of cross section, because we know tension is equal to stress into area. So if when stress is given, we can find out the area of cross section of the cable. So like this, so they may ask any value by giving the required data. So this is where we have stopped in the last lecture. We have discussed one problem and finding out the value of horizontal tension is another important parameter, horizontal tension. So how to find out the horizontal tension? Once you find out the horizontal tension, by knowing VA or VB, we can find out the value of T max. So this is where we have stopped in the last lecture. So this is to summarize what we have discussed earlier. Also, I not mentioned anything about the books. There are many good books in structural analysis. In addition, we have also done one book, Structural Analysis Volume 1, Volume 2, Volume 3, and also there is a short answer book. So structural analysis for this topic, Structural Analysis Volume 2 by Dr. R. Vaidyanathan and myself, Elective Publications, New Delhi. This is the publisher. So that also you can refer, because this book covers rolling loads, influence lines, arches, cables, plastic analysis and other topics. So these are the topics that belongs to the current structural analysis too. All these topics are covered. This one book will be sufficient for students doing this subject under Anna University. All the topics are covered in this book, right? So that's about the book. Now in the case of cables without stiffening girder and with supports at different levels, we know how to find out the tension in the suspension cable and also the horizontal tension. Now, so for the benefit of the viewers, I want to do one more small problem on cables with supports at different levels. I'll read the problem and then draw the sketch. The problem is a suspension cable of horizontal span 210 meters. So L equal to 210 meters, horizontal span is supported at two different levels. Supports are at two different levels. The right support is higher than the left support. That means the cable will be, the right support is at a higher level than the left support. So let us say this is support A. Now, as we have discussed, we are taking only the suspended cable. So on this side you will have anchor cable, on this also, on this side also you will have anchor cable, that we will take it up later. The supports, the supporting towers and the anchor cable we will discuss later. We will take only the part of the suspension cable. So this, so support B is at a higher level. A suspension cable of horizontal span 210 meters is supported at two different levels. The right support is higher than the left support by 8 meters. The right support is higher than the left support by 8 meters means the difference in level between the two supports So this is 8 meters. The right support is higher than the left support by 8 meters. The dip of the lowest point in the cable, below the left support is 10 meters. So below the left support, the lowest point in the cable is at a distance of 10 meters. So this is D1. D1 equal to 10 meters. So when the difference in level is 8 meters, then D2 will be equal to 18 meters. From the lowest point, this distance is 18 meters. So difference in level is 8 meters. So the lowest, from the lowest point up to the left support, it is 10 meters. Therefore, D2 equal to 18 meters. The dip of the lowest point, the cable is 10 meters. The cross-sectional area of the cable is 4900 square. So area of cross-sections, capital A or small a, equal to 4900 millimeter square. So this is the cross-sectional area of the cable is 4900 square. Find the uniformly distributed load that can be carried by the cable. What is the value of P? What is the uniformly distributed load that can be carried by the cable if the maximum stress is limited to 700 Newton per mm square? So it says sigma equal to 700 Newton per mm square. So what is the value of UDL? So the problem is, what is the value of UDL? That is the question, right? Right. Now, this is the case. We have to find out the value of UDL. L is given. L is 210 meters. So, the horizontal span from here up to the right support is 200, L equal to 210 meters. L equal to 210 meters. Right. Now, what is the value of P? Right. Now, the supports are different levels. Therefore, from A to the lowest point and the distance from C to the highest point will not be the same. It is unsymmetrical. If this is the lowest point in the cable, let us call this distance as L1 and this distance as L2. L1 and L2 will not be the same here because it is unsymmetrical. Supports are at different levels. Right. And here, they have given the value of area and sigma. That means that value of T max is given. T max equal to stress into area, because cable will take only direct tension. So tensile stress is given, area is given. So stress in the area will give you the tensile force, right? So the maximum tension in the cable is 4900 into 4900, so many newtons. So newtons, that value equal to 3.43 into 10 power 6 newtons. That is the maximum tension in the cable. So this is available. Now we have got the value of T max, right? Now you have to find out the value of L1 and L2, because L1 and L2, we know L1 by L2 equal to root of D1 by D2, right? L1 by L2 equal to root of D1 equal to 10 meters. D1 is 10 meters. D2 is 10 plus 8 equal to 18 meters. So D2 equal to 18 meters. Therefore, you can find out the value of L1. L1 equal to, from this we find that L1 equal to 0.745 L2. So there are two unknowns. We have used only one equation. The other equation is L1 plus L2 equal to 210 meters. L1 plus L2 equal to 210 meters. Or we can find out the value of L2. L2 equal to 210 minus L1. So this we can substitute here. That is, in this equation, suppose if we substitute L1 equal to 0.745 into L2. L2 equal to 210 minus L1. So L1, L2 equal to 210 minus L1. Now this also L1, this is also L1. We can find out the value of L1 and then we can find out the value of L2. There are two unknowns, there are two equations. So solving, we will get L1 equal to 89.656 meters and L2 equal to 120.344 meters. So L1 is 89.89656. L2 equal to 120. That is about L1 and L2. Now, once if we get L1 and L2, the vertical reaction here, vertical reaction VA equal to P into L1. That is, from the lowest point, the entire load will be taken by the support A. Again, on the right hand side, from the lowest point up to the support B, the load will be carried by the support B. This is B. So VB equal to P into L2. P into L2, VA equal to P into L1. And the horizontal tension here, H equal to P L1 square by 2D1. When the supports are at the same level, the formula is P L square by 8D. When the supports are different levels, VA equal to P L1 square by 2D1, H equal to, and here this horizontal tension values will be the same, but the formula is here H equal to P L2 square by 2D2. Numerical value will be same. Both will have the same value. H A will be equal to HB, but L1 and L2. So you would use the formula and find out the horizontal tension. Therefore, what we can do is VA equal to P into L1. So P is unknown, into L1 equal to 89.656. So this is equal to 89.656 P, because P is unknown, we do not know. VB equal to P into L2. The intensity of UDL is P per unit length, P per unit length into L2. Whatever is L2, whatever is the load here, that will be taken by the support B. From the lowest point up to B, the length is L2 on the right hand side. So P into L2 will be the reaction on the right hand side. So P into L2, P is unknown, L2 is known, L2 is 120.344. So 120.344, that is L2 into P. Again, P is not known. P is not known. Right. Now, next is that of H, the horizontal tension. horizontal tension P L1 square by 2D1, or both will be the same, both will give the same value, P L2 square by 2D2, both will give the same value. Let us make use of the second one, but the number will be the same, both will be giving you the same value. P is unknown, again P is unknown. L2 is 120.344 square, P L2 square by 2D2, D2 equal to 18 meters. So this on simplification will give you 402.3p. On simplification, that will give you 402.3p. So this will also give you the same value. But why we are concentrating on B is, when you find out the value of T max, T max here will be root of VA square plus H square. Now here T max will be, T max here will be root of VB square plus H square. In comparing L1 and L2, we find L2 is more. Therefore, of these two values, of these two values, we find VB is more. VB is more. Therefore, this tension will be maximum. This is on the at a higher level. This is at a higher level. Therefore, T max at the B will be more, because support B is at a higher level. Therefore, we are concentrating on B. Otherwise, H will be same, right? So that is about the value of the horizontal tension. Horizontal tension. Now, after finding out these values, we know T max equal to root of V square plus H square. V square plus H square. We know VB is more, so we want maximum tension. Therefore, VB square plus H square equal to root of VB is 120.344 P square plus 402.3 P square. Right. This will also avoid. Right. So VB we have taken, and H also we have used. Therefore, we can rub off. So we have taken the important values. Right. So what we can do is, we can use T max. We know T max equal to 3.43 into 10 power 6 newtons. So 3.43 into 10 power 6 equal to, see, this is P square. This is also P square. So P square you can take outside the root. So that will become P into root of 120.344 square. P square we have taken outside. Plus 402.3. Here again we have taken this P square outside. So that is this P. Therefore, this square. So we find, it's a number. This is a number. P is the only unknown. Therefore, 3.43 into 10 power 6 divided by this value. This value equal to P. So that will give you the value of P. Now P equal to 8.168 newton per meter, or equal to 8.168 kilonewton per meter. So this is how we have to find out. So instead of giving the value of P L and asking what is T max, they are given the value of T max indirectly in the form of stress and area of cross section. So we can find out T max from which indirectly you'll have to go back and just find out the value of. So this is how you have to do problem. Sometimes in a problem giving all values, you may be asked to find out the value of L. If you are able to know the basic formulas, we can just manage anything. We can just manage anything. So after this, we can find out the value of T max. T max equal to root of now we know the value of P. Once if you know the value of P, 8.168 kilonewton meter, we can find out the value of VA. We can find out the value of VA. VA equal to say 89.656 into P1 into P. VA equal to 89 point something into P, that we can find out. Number is, now P is known. VB, we can find out VB equal to 120.344 into P into P. So P into L2, P into L2. So P is known now, L2 is already known. We can find out the value of there. Then we can find out the value of T max. T max equal to root of VB square plus H square. Because once we find out the value of P, we can find out the value of VBR, H also we can find out. So VB is known, H is known, we can find out the value of T max. So T max we can find out. T max equal to root of VB square plus H square, that we can find out. So or in this formula we can substitute and find out the, because P is known, 8.168, therefore we can find out the value of T max. So coming to minimum tension, so this tension will be less because compared to VB, VA is less. So tension will be less, but that will not be the minimum tension. Always the minimum tension will occur at the lowest point in the cable. So here at this point, the lowest point, V equal to 0, because this is VA, that is P into L1 minus P into L1, and here V will become 0. Here also it is VB, P into L2, so PL2 minus P into L2 will become 0. Here the vertical force will be equal to 0, therefore when the vertical force is 0 at any point, you know T equal to root of V square plus H square. Therefore when V is 0, it is root of H square only, therefore T equal to H. That is the horizontal tension itself. Therefore, the lowest minimum tension will occur at the lowest point at the cable, and that minimum tension is equal to H itself. So, by comparing VA and VB, we should not write VB is maximum and TB is maximum, TA is minimum. No, not that. This is less, but this is the minimum. This is the minimum. The minimum tension will occur at the lowest point, whose value is equal to the horizontal tension itself. So that is first problem, right? We'll take one more problem before completing this lecture. Next problem is a cable subjected to uniformly distributed loads and one or two concentrated loads. If the concentrated loads are symmetrical, the shape of the cable will be parabolic. Suppose if it is not symmetrical, may be subjected to one non-central load or two non-central loads, the cable may not be symmetrical. So in the case of cable subjected to uniformly distributed load and asymmetrical concentrated loads, locating the point of maximum dip is the main problem, because from the lowest point the load on the left hand side will be taken by support A or left support, from the lowest point to the right support, whatever it is the load will be taken by the right support, because that will not be at the center. If the loading is not symmetrical, the dip, the maximum dip will not be at the center. We have to find out where V equal to zero. So that is a important point to be remembered, with which we will take up a numerical example. I will read the problem and then draw the sketch. A suspension cable having supports at the same level. So suspension cable having supports at the same level. Supports are at the same level. Support A and support B at the same level. Right. Supports same level. Has a horizontal span of 165 meters. So the value of L equal to 165 meters, and maximum dip of 15 meters. So dip is maximum, but we do not know where the maximum dip will occur. D equal to 15 meters. We just mark, but it is not at the center. Of course, this will be known only after knowing the loading. Still, the cable is loaded with a UDL of, the cable is loaded with a UDL of 40 kilonewtons per meter. So the UDL is 40 kilonewtons per meter. So P equal to 40 kilonewton per meter, right, throughout its length, and concentrated loads of 150 kilonewton and 300 kilonewtons at one-third points. So 165 means 165 by 3 will be 55. 165 by 3 equal to 55 meters, right. There is one load here, there is a concentrated load of 150 kilonewton at one-third point. One-third point means this value equal to 55 meters. There is another concentrated load of 300 kilonewton, that is two-third point. That means this is another 55, this is 55. So 3 into 55, one-third point and a two-third point. So here the loading is not symmetrical, therefore the maximum dip will not occur at the center, because you know the cable is completely flexible. Depending upon the position of the load, the cable will go on changing its shape. So this is the problem. What is the maximum tension in the cable? T max. What is the value of T max? This is the question. What is the value of T max? This is the question. All values are given. Now VA and VB will not be equal. Cable is supported at the same level. Now VA will not be equal to VB, as in the case of UDL. In the case of UDL, VA equal to VB equal to P into L by 2. So here there are two concentrated loads. Therefore, by taking moment support B, we can find out VA. So VA into 165 minus UDL 40 into 165 into 165 by 2 minus, there are two point loads. One load is 300 is at, it is a 55 from B, minus 150 into 110 equal to 0. This is a UDL and point load. 300 150 are the point load. By taking moment about B, we just get these values. So we find VA equal to, by simplifying, 165 VA equal to 577,500 and VA equal to 3,500 kilonewtons. VA equal to 3,000. So this is VA 3,500 kilonewtons. And VB equal to total load minus VA. VB equal to total load. Total load is 40 kilonewton per meter over a length of 165 meters. Plus there is a point load of 150. Plus there is a point load of 300. This is the total load. Total load. Total load minus VA. VA is 3,500. 500 will give you VB equal to 3,550 kilonewtons. 3,500. So VB equal to 3,550 kilonewtons. Right. So that is about the values of VA and VB. Now, the horizontal tension is PL squared by 8D. If the cable is support the same level and subjected to UDL, it is PL squared by 8D. Now here the cable is not symmetrical. So only when we know the dip value of the dip and also the location of the maximum dip, you will be able to find out the horizontal tension. Therefore, as it is, H cannot be found out, because when you take moment about this point, only when the distance is known, we will be able to say this horizontal into this dip. So that is not known. Therefore, that value, the maximum dip will occur at the point where the vertical force equal to 0. You know, at the point of the lowest, at the maximum dip, the value of V equal to 0. Therefore, the shape of the cable is not parabolic. Let us assume that, of course, it is obvious, there are only two loads. The maximum dip will occur between the two points. Let it be at a distance of x. We do not know. Let it be at a distance of x. At the point of the maximum dip, V equal to 0. So considering the equilibrium of the left-hand side of the cable or the right hand side of the cable. Let us consider the equilibrium of the left hand side of the cable. We want V equal to 0. So one is VA minus 40 into X. That is not known. X that is not known. Minus 150. 150 minus 40 into X. VA minus 40 into X minus 1. The vertical force equal to 0. Some of the vertical force equal to V equal to 0. So this is equal to 0. So this will give you the value of X, because VA is 3,500. This is known. Therefore, only unknown is X. X equal to 83.75. X equal to 83.75 meters. So this is the point at which the vertical force equal to 0. So VA is 3,500 upwards minus this P into X minus this value equal to 0, this 150, this value 150 equal to 0 here. So for that, the value of X equal to 83.75 meters. So when this is 83.75, this value will be 165 minus 83.75. right? We'll right. So this is the value, of course. Now we'll find out the value of. We'll take moment about the. Now we have to find out the value of h. So h equal to for finding out the value of h, you'll have to take moment about the lowest point, about this point. So when you take moment about the lowest point, it is V A into 83.75 minus UDL 40 into minus this UDL 83.75 by 2, that is UDL minus. So we have to consider all the forces to the left of this section. To the left of this section, we have VA is there, UDL is there, concentrated load is there. Concentrated load is 150. So minus 150 into 83.75 minus 55. That is, this is 83.75, this is 55. Therefore, this distance equal to 83.75 minus 55 minus h. So this is the line of action of the horizontal thrust. The horizontal thrust into d. D equal to 15 meters. H into 15 equal to 0. Now we have considered all the forces to the left of the section. Now VA is known. VA is 3500. So all other values are numbers except H. So that will give you the horizontal tension. The horizontal tension equal to 9902. The horizontal tension is equal to 9902 kilonewton. That is one value. Now, we have been asked to find out the value of the maximum tension. So, H, here it is 9902, here also it is 9902. 9902 kilonewtons. Now, compared to VA and VB, comparing VA and VB, we find VB is more. We know T equal to root of V square plus H square. This is T max, root of VB square plus H square. Therefore, T max equal to root of VB square, because VB is more, plus H square. Now, VB is 3550 square. Plus H square is 9902 square. Now this value T max equal to 10519 kilonewton. T max maximum tension is equal to 519 kilonewton. This is at the support B. So that is how we have to solve the problem. So this is how we will have to solve the problem. When the supports are the same level, but because of two unsymmetric loading, there are two concentrated loads, in that case you have to deal with the problem. So the main point is where the value of V is zero, because we know at the lowest point in the cable the value of V equal to zero. We have discussed the same in the case of cable supported at different levels also. Here also that is a fact. So that we have to locate. So there only we will have the maximum dip. And here also we have got the value of T max. So T minimum, so this is T max, this T will be less, but T minimum will occur only at the lowest point. T minimum equal to root of H square equal to H itself. Therefore, the minimum tension in this cable also, in this also, is equal to the horizontal tension. H is equal to 9902. This is T minimum, which will occur at the lowest point in the cable. So that is how we'll have to deal problems subjected to a combination of uniformly distributed load and two or three or four concentrated loads. So that completes this lecture. Thank you.